Hello everyone! In this video, we are going to introduce you to a fun way to learn to code on the go with PictoBlocks, a graphical programming software, now in the form of smartphone application. First, we'll have a look at the application version of PictoBlocks, then explore its UI, and finally, write a small script to make our sprite Toby move. Let's begin. Similar to the desktop version, the PictoBlocks app is a graphical programming platform based on Scratch blocks for you to learn to code anytime, anywhere. Its user-friendly interface and drag-and-drop functionality make programming fun and interactive. Just like in the desktop version, you can make games and animations, control robots, and even program prototyping boards like Arduino Uno, Mega, ESP32, and Evive with the app as well. To install the app, pause the video here, go to the link given in the description box and download it. Resume once you're all set. Now that you have the PictoBlocks app, let's have a quick look at its interface. Tap the plus button on the bottom right corner of the screen to start with a new project. Similar to its desktop version, there's a purple colored menu bar at the top. On the bar, you'll notice the icon of a character. That's Toby, the sprite selected by default in the beginning. A sprite is nothing but an object or a character that performs different actions in the projects. On the left is the block palette with blocks of different colors that are used for creating scripts in the scripting area on the right. A script is nothing but the code that we write. There are four buttons in the scripting area: undo, redo, zoom in, and zoom out. Many things are somewhat similar to the desktop version except for a few, including the stage. Next, tap the maximize icon on the bottom right corner to see the stage, the area where the sprite performs actions according to your code. To the right of the stage are the arrow keys. You can use them to move the sprite in different directions or as specified in the script. Now to understand each element, let's create a small script to make Toby move. First, let's make the stage a bit more colorful. We can do that by changing the backdrop. Now to change the backdrop, tap the Add Backdrop button available above the block palette. Tap it again, you'll see an Edit button. Click it to open the backdrop settings. In doing so, the stage will appear along with the palette on its left, similar to the one we have in the desktop version. Now, tap the Choose a Backdrop button on the bottom left corner to open PictoBlocks library of backdrops and choose a backdrop of your choice. We are going for forest. As soon as you select the desired backdrop, the white background of the stage is replaced by the background you have chosen. The small card in the stage palette shows the recently selected backdrop. Now that the stage is all set, let's go back to creating the script. Tap the back button on the top left corner to go back to the scripting area. Since we are creating the script for Toby, we must first select Toby's icon. Let's create a script to make Toby move. We are going to use blocks from the motion palette. Go to the motion palette and drag and drop a move steps block into the scripting area. This block will make Toby move the number of steps you enter into the white space. Write 5 in the space given. To make Toby move continuously, we are going to use a forever block from the control palette. Now, he should change the direction as soon as he reached the edge of the stage. For this, we'll use an if on edge bounce block from the motion palette. Next, add a set rotation style block below the bounce block and select left right from the drop down to make sure that Toby does not turn upside down upon reaching the edge. Now, tap the script to run it. You'll notice that the green flag at the bottom gets replaced by the stop button represented by a red octagon. Switch to the stage to see Toby moving. You'll notice that he's moving too fast. To slow him down, stop the script and go back to the scripting area. From the control palette, drag and drop a weight block below the set rotation style block and write 0.1 in the white space. This will add a delay of 0.1 seconds every time the loop starts executing again. Now, you might have noticed that so far, we have had to click the script every time to run it. Instead of having to click it manually, there's something else that we can use to ease things for us, a head block. A head block is a block with a bump at its top and is used to start a script based on a predefined condition. Go to the events palette and drag and drop a when flag clicked head block above the forever block. Now go to the stage and then tap the green flag to start the script. Toby seems to be moving with the required pace but does not seem to be actually walking. Let's create another script to make him look like he's walking. Stop the current script and go back to the scripting area. Then tap Toby's icon once. Three buttons will appear below it. The one on the left is the edit button. Tapping it will open the sprite settings. Tap the costume button. You'll see that there are many appearances or costumes. Out of them, switching between walking 1 and walking 2 will make Toby look like he's walking. Now, let's go back to the script. Since we are working on Toby's look, we are going to use blocks from the looks palette. Drag and drop a switch costume 2 block into the scripting area. Select Toby walking 1 from the drop-down. Long press on the block to duplicate it. Select Toby walking 2 from the drop-down of the second switch costume 2 block. Add a wait block with a delay of 0.2 seconds below each switch costume 2 block and stack all the blocks together. Add a forever block to run the script forever. Finally, add a when flag clicked head block above the script. Since both these scripts have the same head block, they'll run together whenever we click the flag. Now, go to the stage, then click the flag button. With this, your first project is ready. You can create as many animations as you want to in PictoBlocks just like this. That's it for this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For more such educational videos, subscribe to STEMpedia and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Bye-bye!